Hey, Chris Menard here. Got a great video I'm going to cover in Excel, the compound annual growth rate, CAGR. I'm going to show you five different ways to do it. I'm also going to cover the rule of 72, which I've done an extensive video on before, but great time to throw it in here. I'll keep it real short on that one. And as a bonus, I'll show you the formula to figure out the future value of an amount without manually having to do it. Let's dive in right now. So here's my example. We happen to be in January of 2024 right now. Assume that you got $20,000. You either invested it yourself, maybe someone passed it on to you. You want to put that $20,000 away, and you believe that you'll get 8% annualized every year. Just so you know this, I want to pull this up. The S&P 500 has always been positive over a range of years. 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, 25, going back 50 years, it's always done over 9% annualized. So my 8% is a realistic number. So I want to know how much I'm going to have in 10 years. This is my example. And we're not putting any more money into it either. It's just a one-time, throw it in there. Let's see what happens. So just to get this started, let's do this. All right, so I'm going to take the years down, and we will stop at, I'm going to just leave it at 11 years. We'll see, though, at 10. Here, keep it official. There's 10 years. Over in H1, you could type in 20,000, but let's do a 3D reference. That way, if I change cell C2, it changes in H1. Now, year one, I'm going to get that 8%, so 20,000 times 8% is an additional $1,600. That should end up being $21,600. Absolute reference this, F4, perfect. Control enter, autofill, double click. There you go. So at 10 years, I come up with $43,178. Let's check this with the rule of 72. In case you're wondering, what in the world is the rule of 72? Just a personal investment financial rule said is if you take the number 72 and you divide that by the compound annual growth rate, that will be the number of years that it takes for your money to double. So basically in this example, 20,000 going to 40,000. Let's just see if that's correct real quick. 72, 8%, 72 divided by 8. 9 years. I could have done that in my head, by the way. So if we look at the 9-year mark, our $20,000 is $39,980. Close enough in this example. One more if you just want to see it. If I say, I'm not going to do it, but if you change this to 7% and then change that to 7, here I'll do it real quick. Let's go 7%. It's going to take 10.25, 1.07. 10 years. Yeah, we're still getting there. A little over 10 years, 10.28 years. At 10 years, I'm at 39. Get it a little bit more, we'll be at the 40,000. I am going to undo to put this back the way it was. But that is your rule 72. Cool rule. So now, method one is what I just did, manually doing this in Excel. And if you don't have Excel, this would be very time consuming, but you could do this. Well, let's look at the different formulas. So here is the official CAGR formula. This is not an Excel function. It's just a pure formula. You take the ending balance. Let's go with this number right here. You divide by the base balance or the beginning balance. And notice you divide, you don't subtract. And then you're going to raise this to the power of 1 divided by how many years? 10 years. And then you subtract 1. Right there is the official compound annual growth rate formula. I've already formatted this as percentage and I increased the decimal 2 times, but there you go, exactly 8%. So that was method 2, just using the formula. Method 3 is using an Excel function, rate of return. equals RRI 10 years. I'm going to type in the 10. You're normally allowed to reference the cells, comma. What is the PV, the present value? Well, it's $20,000, comma. What is that going to be worth in the future? FV is future value. Three arguments in here. All three are required. And once again, I formatted this as a percentage already with that one. Another method in Excel, another function, is the power function. Equals power. What number do you want? H11 divided by H1, comma. Very similar to what we've been doing. 1 divided by 10. And again, that would give me 1.08, so I'm going to subtract 1. To keep up with these, I know I got one more to do. I got a couple things to do here. Let me do the formula text over here so you can actually just keep up with what I'm doing. I know I haven't done that last one yet. I'll move them over a tad, and I'll shrink them down just a little bit. So there's what I'm doing. And the last one that we're going to do is the rate function. Number of periods is 10 periods, comma. Payment, how much money are you contributing every period? Well, for us, it's 0. I could have left that blank. What's your present value? And this function requires that the future value be a negative. There you go. Again, the formatting is done. So there are one formula, 3 Excel functions I just covered, and then the manual way over here, right over here. So now the question is, well, Chris, you knew you were putting in and assuming that 8%. What is this going to be worth in 30 years from now? So here's the formula for this one. It is H1 times 1 plus 2. So I'm not looking 10 years out. I'm making this up. Let's say you're 30. I'm keeping this easy. Make sure you're 30 years old. You got that $20,000. What is this going to be worth when you're 60, 30 years from now? We're going to raise to the power of 30. $201,253.14. Is that correct? Let's see if this is working. Yes, this is working. Just to prove this, I'm going to take this out to 30 years. 30 years, $201,253. It is working. And to keep it official, there are the functions or formulas that I used. Anyway, make sure you should always know the rule of 72, just a great rule to use. And y'all should be able to figure out how, I don't care whether you use the formula or one of these functions, y'all to figure out what is this going to be worth in the future. If I invest it, if you save it, you're not going to get it. A savings account's not going to get it, but if you invest it, you could. Once somebody's going to say this in the comments, let me go ahead and cover it. Chris, the market could go down. Absolutely true. It was down in 2022. It was down in 2018. It was down in 2008. But overall, the history always up over 9% from all the data that I've looked at. Well, there you go. Feel free to subscribe to my channel. If you like this video, I have a Microsoft Excel online training course. Also have a Microsoft Teams online training course. Hope you have a wonderful day. Thank you.